All right. Hey, I'm Aaron from the band Copeland. Well, the aesthetic, I mean, like you said, the aesthetic that we were going for on the record was, you know, this is this line between lovely and creepy that, you know, if you imagine a photograph of a lovely field full of flowers, or a little girl standing in a field full of flowers, it would be just a lovely image. But if there was an ominous shadow kind of looming that you couldn't tell what was just out of frame, all of a sudden you would have a very spooky photo. And it's like this line that's like so thin, and it's an aesthetic that we've really been fascinated with since we started making the third record. And I think a lot of the inspiration came from just a lot of the music that we listen to. I feel like Radiohead is like the master of that line, because their music is so haunting and so dark, and but so beautiful. If you know, like it could be like just this lovely soundtrack, but you know, he's talking about getting eaten by worms. You know, it's like it's just like this great juxtaposition, and I don't know, it's something that I really respond to, just both in visual art and in music. I really like it a lot. Yeah, I think the lyrics on the record are pretty dark for the most part, and I think the brightness and the lush feeling of the music does a good job to counter the dark lyrics. But I mean, I think musically and lyrically both have like moments of like hope versus sorrow, and I just really like that contrast. I think when I was younger, I wanted to go through a record and go from trouble to sorrow to joy, and have it like wrap up in a nice little package by the end of the record. And I think as I've gotten older, I've realized that, you know, like that's not the way life is. You know, like people's problems aren't fixed in 3 minutes, and people's problems aren't fixed in 45 minutes for a record. I don't feel like, you know, like I can really appropriately delve into an emotion and have it come full circle in 45 minutes. I don't feel like it needs to. I could, but I feel like to some extent that's a little bit corny to like have a sweet happy ending at the end of the record. So the end of You Are My Sunshine is kind of becomes an amalgamation of all of the emotions that go through the record. The last song wasn't really meant to be an album track. It was meant to be a soundtrack for an art gallery. It was gonna play over loudspeakers in an art gallery, and it has like these very abstract lyrics, you know. And as you move around the gallery, depending on what piece you were looking at which time, you might be hearing a different lyric, and it would make the piece of art seem a little different to you. So you might have a really fond memory while you were looking at one piece, and you'd move on, and all of a sudden the song has turned into kind of a swirling, ominous thing, and so that would make the art seem a little different. So the idea was that you could move about the art gallery a few times, and each piece would seem slightly subtly different every time you moved around. And so it was kind of an experiment in that. And the art show never wound up happening, and so the song got put on the Copeland record, and which I really like, because I really feel like it ties up every little loose end that goes on in the record. Yeah, I think music is like that in general, that, you know, depending on where you are in your life and, you know, your day-to-day life, you're, you know, like, had a great day and you're driving home from a great party, you know, a song would mean one thing to you, whereas if you were like, you know, having like a really rough day, you know, maybe the same song would hit you in a slightly different place. So yeah, I mean, I think that's just true with music in general, that it would mean different things to you at different points in your life. I think with songwriting in general is how I came to the conclusion that, you know, I don't really need to wrap up. I don't really need to make every, you know, every trouble have a happy ending by the end of the record. And I think to some extent it's more powerful. It can be more powerful for someone if it doesn't like totally wrap up by the end, because I just don't think our lives are like that. The biggest thing that I've learned, I think over the last few records that we've made, the biggest kind of musical lesson that I've learned is the kind of less is more approach to making records. Not loading a song up with 10 guitar tracks and stacks of vocals and an orchestra and several different keys. It's streamlining everything and making the parts a little bit more concise. And the same thing can be said lyrically. Not trying to cover too much ground, and not trying to be so specific with instances and so specific with situations in the lyrics that that it becomes too specific to a particular event, because that can probably rule people out from really attaching their own experiences to the songs. I learned the lesson pretty quick not to make my lyrics too specific. The first record was just the whole thing was written about one 2-year span of my life, and I delved into every single emotion that I felt in the 2 years, and it was very specific. Every specific moments were described, and I felt like I kind of trapped myself and limited myself to what I could write about after writing that record, because a lot of people were expecting the sequel, or they were expecting to see how the they were expecting the next record to be the personal in the same way, and I just wasn't in that place anymore. I was 5 years older than when I wrote some of those other songs. It just wasn't in my head to write like that anymore. I think writing has become less therapeutic for me. Maybe lyric writing, as I've gotten older, has become less therapeutic than maybe the musical side. I think I get a big charge out of writing a melody and writing a chord progression or writing a groove than I do writing a verse. No, I don't think they're the same at all. I don't really feel like poetry and lyrics and sung lyrics are equatable. The lyrics for me are, as long as I'm not embarrassed by the lyrics, I'm good. I get much more of a charge out of writing the music and the arrangement and the strings, and the musical part is definitely the forefront for me. The lyrics are in place just so, because I can't sing la la la. And I don't want to be embarrassed by bad lyrics. But I think poetry and lyrics are two totally different things. I wouldn't think of myself as a poet at all. Just because I don't think I have the passion for it, for that type of writing. Actually, it would be perfect for me is something like a Sigur Rós type of thing where I could sing, because definitely my strongest instrument is my voice, but I don't really get that big of a charge out of writing lyrics. So if I could just kind of do a gibberish sort of, if I could get away with gibberish, I would be in a good spot, but I don't think I can get away with it. Not at this point anyway.